Assalamu alaikum. I'm from New York City, so I'm not impressed. Assalamu alaikum. So I am so honored and privileged and humbled to be here with all of you today. I came all the way on a 6-hour flight because CARE LA was worth it. I am so honored to be here to support this fabulous organization. If there was something called the CARE Defense League of America, Linda Sarsour would be the president of it, and we might have to go on that right now. So I may be just launching that here at the CARE LA 20th anniversary banquet. People keep seeing me and asking me, Sister Linda, how are you doing? And I'm telling everybody that how am I doing? I am more unapologetically Muslim today than I ever was unapologetically Muslim. Not only at this time do we have to be unapologetically Muslim, but we have every right in these United States of America to be unapologetically Muslim. Sisters and brothers, where do we find that strength? We find that strength in our ancestors. Over 460 years ago, before these United States of America were even called the United States of America, our ancestors, 25 to 30% of enslaved Africans who came to these United States of America were Muslim. Sisters and brothers, if enslaved people can figure out how to pray, how to fast, and how to be Muslim and connected to their faith under the watch of slave masters, then you have no choice but to be unapologetically Muslim. Sisters and brothers, in the honor of those who came before you, so you could be sitting in this room today unapologetically Muslim, people who sacrificed more than you ever will sacrifice for you to call yourself a Muslim in America, I ask you that you leave here today with your head held high, your back straighter than ever, and your faith stronger than ever, because that's what we will continue to be in this country. Sisters and brothers, our nightmare is being actualized in the White House. White supremacists, anti-Semites, Islamophobes, anti-women and anti-immigrant zealots are the leadership reigning on us in the White House. People who hate everything that you are, everything that you stand for, or the values and the principles that we hold as a community. But you know what? I'm not afraid. I am more committed and more devoted to our communities and to these United States of America more than I ever have in the past 20 years that I've been doing this work. Sisters and brothers, we have heroes. Heroes and people that we need to challenge. I want you to ask yourself a question over the course of the past 15 years as we as Muslims find ourselves in a worse situation than we were even days and weeks and months after 9/11. This that we are in, the moment we are in, is basically our second 9/11 moment. Why are we experiencing this moment? And I'm gonna tell you, my dear sisters and brothers, and I'm gonna be super honest with you because I'm from Brooklyn and I'm channeling my Palestinian today. I'm gonna keep it real. Appeasing people in power, appeasing white supremacy, appeasing white power has done nothing for our communities. It is time for us to stop working towards acceptance and start demanding the respect and dignity that our communities have always deserved. No longer will we allow leadership to sell our souls to those who do not have our best interests at heart. Only we have our community's best interests at heart. Sisters and brothers, moving forward, justice in Islam has never been just us. So while we think about how to protect and defend Muslim communities, I want to ask you, the Muslim community, what are you willing to do? What are you prepared to do to defend and protect other communities who are also going to be directly impacted by this white supremacist administration? Are you ready to open your mosques as sanctuaries for undocumented people? Are you willing to stand up for the rights of African Americans? Yes, those in our community and those outside of our community. Are you ready to be a voice of conscience, a voice of power, the moral compass of this nation when they need us most? Sisters and brothers, the time is now. Not yesterday. Let's not talk about the past. Let's talk about the future.